This week's lab's called the ideal gas constant, and not surprisingly, we're going to be working with the ideal gas law. You remember that there are four bulk properties of gases: pressure, volume, temperature, and amount. And if we, in this lab, measure all four of them, we can actually come up with an experimental value for the gas constant R, and then we can use that to see how well our experiment worked. The first two things you're told to do as you look at your procedure is to calculate the length of magnesium ribbon that you're supposed to use, and I've outlined those calculations for you here on this piece of paper. Basically use the standard molar volume to try and figure out about how many moles of hydrogen gas would represent about 25 milliliters. And then because of the one-to-one stoichiometry of the reaction that you've seen before, we can turn that into a mass amount of magnesium, and then using the lineal density of the magnesium ribbon, we can get an approximate length of ribbon to cut and use in our experiment. The exact amount doesn't really matter. We're going to run this experiment with excess hydrochloric acid, but somewhere in the vicinity of a couple of centimeters is about what we're looking at. Once you have your ribbon cut, then you're told to build a copper cage for the ribbon using a thin piece of copper wire. Most students fold the ribbon at least once, sometimes fold it even more than once, twice, and then kind of wrap that thin piece of copper around your magnesium ribbon. You're trying to keep the ribbon from escaping the cage until the very end of the reaction so it doesn't float to the top of your test tube and stick to the side and fail to completely react. So you just wrap that copper wire around there until you're sort of happy with what it looks like as a cage, and then proceed to the next step. You're going to use some of these big test tubes with a stopper that are already set out for you, and you're directed to put about 5 milliliters of concentrated hydrochloric acid, so be careful. Again, the exact amount doesn't really matter because we're going to run it with plenty of acid. And I'll just put some in here to show the basic idea. And then we're going to fill up the rest of the volume in the test tube with DI water. If you do it very, very carefully, very little of the acid will actually mix with the water because it's heavier. You're going to fill it right to the tippy, tippy, tippy top. And then you're going to take your caged piece of magnesium and put it in the test tube and stick it down, which is, of course, going to be up when you flip it over, maybe a couple centimeters or something. You want to keep it near the bottom where the acid is going to be most concentrated. So as you then have that in there, you're going to go ahead and put the stopper in the test tube, put your finger over the hole, and invert it in a beaker that has been half filled with water previously. And so we can see there that the acid has traveled down to the magnesium ribbon and is producing that single replacement reaction where we're making soluble magnesium chloride and hydrogen gas. You can see the hydrogen gas collecting in the top of the test tube because the acid is concentrated and hydrochloric acid is a strong acid. The reaction runs quite quickly, and in a quite short period of time the entire reaction will be done. You don't have to really worry too much about it. You don't have to hold it or anything since the excess liquid is being pushed out of the hole in the bottom. You can see the bubbles forming and the test tube sort of filling up with that hydrogen gas. When we're all done and the bubbles stop, you're going to need a method for marking the volume of gas in the bottom, now the top, of that test tube so we can figure it out after we get rid of all the excess liquid. And so what you're told to do with your procedure is to go ahead and kind of mark it with your thumb, and then as you pull it out of there, transfer that thumb mark to a mark using a Sharpie. I'm just going to pull it out right now before it's done, just to illustrate the principle. So I'm putting my thumb right on the volume, and then I'm going to go ahead and use the Sharpie to mark it. And then, although it's not completely reacted yet, I'm going to dump out the reaction mixture, and then I can easily fill up the test tube to my mark, and then using a suitable graduated cylinder, figure out what the volume of liquid is, which is the same, of course, as the volume of the gas. Got the volume of the gas, we have the atmospheric pressure from the internet, we have the temperature using a temperature probe while the reaction is running, and we also have the mole amount of hydrogen, and so we can calculate the experimental value of the gas constant and use that to evaluate how well the experiment worked. Have fun.